Ayer aprendimos que la adoración es postrados.
Standing up is falsa.
Estar de pie es falso.
Aleluya.
Praise is not worship.
Estar cantando ahí no es adoración.
Praise is honoring God for what He's done.
Es darle la gloria por lo que Él hace. Por
He had beautiful praise tonight.
Y fue una adoración, una alabanza muy bonita.
Everybody was dancing, singing.
En la alabanza todo el mundo cantó.
Shouting, running.
Gritó.
God inhabits the praises of His people.
Porque le dimos la alabanza.
So you keep the praise.
Podemos seguir alabando.
You welcome the Holy Spirit.
Para la bienvenida del Espíritu Santo.
And now we pass into the Holy of Holies.
Porque ahora vamos a entrar al lugar santísimo.
What's performed in the Holy of Holies is worship.
La forma para entrar al lugar santísimo es la adoración.
That's what's performed in the Holy of Holies, worship.
Esa es la forma, esa es la adoración.
So on the Bible, I'll show you tonight.
Porque ayer les enseñamos también el que dice la palabra.
What we find last night as pastor and his wife taught us.
Ayer el pastor y su esposa.
As Pastor Eduardo and his wife taught us last night. That worship is not standing up.
Estuvimos aprendiendo que la adoración no es de pie.
I mean, I learned from them last night. Did you?
Porque lo aprendimos todos ayer, ¿cierto?
Sí.
Only a couple learned.
Solo unos cuantos. O todos aprendimos.
That standing up is falsa.
Estar de pie es falso.
Falsa.
Falso.
Has nothing to do with worship.
No es una adoración.
As a matter of fact, there's no place in the Bible.
Eso de nada, ni siquiera está en la Biblia.
Where anybody stands up and worships.
¿O hay algo en la Biblia que dice que adoramos de pie?
And I'll tell you what, if anybody can find me a place in there, I'll take you for lunch.
Si alguien encuentra la Biblia, le invitamos a.
But you won't find it.
Pero no lo van a encontrar.
But now we don't have to go into this bow, kneeling, and prostrate because you've already learned that.
Pero ya tuvimos el aprendizaje de que hay que postrarse, inclinarse.
Tonight.
Pero esta noche.
That again, is going to change your life now.
Te va a cambiar sus vidas ahora.
This is about intimacy.
This is what we're going to say.
He wants spiritual intercourse with you.
Él quiere un contacto espiritual cercano.
The word intercourse means coming together. Yes.
Lo que quiere decir es el desencuentro, es estar cercanos, unidos.
Comprende? Spiritual intercourse, meaning two, shall become uno.
Esa unión espiritual es que dos se hacen uno.
Isn't this what you desire?
¿Eso no es lo que deseamos?
Isn't this what you yearn for?
¿Eso no es por lo que estamos siempre pidiendo?
You're not in this faith to come to church. You're in this faith because you need an encounter, what we spoke about yesterday. An encounter.
Porque estamos buscando encuentros cercanos.
With Christ.
Con Cristo.
He's alive.
Porque está vivo.
He has risen from the dead.
Porque se levantó de la muerte.
That's what makes our faith different.
Por eso es que ahora es diferente.
This is not a religion.
Porque no es una leyenda.
This is an encounter with the Almighty God.
Porque ese es un encuentro con el poderoso Señor.
And only a priest can have this encounter.
Y solo el sacerdote puede tener ese encuentro.
You may not know what I'm talking about yet.
Usted todavía no sabe de qué estoy hablando.
But you know something?
¿Sabes algo?
By the end of tonight,
al final de esta noche,
you're going to know exactly what I'm talking about.
Vas a ver exactamente de qué estoy hablando.
It's okay.
¿Está bien?
It's okay.
¿Está bien?
Just hold on and watch.
Solamente vea y observe. Espere y observe.
You see, you can hear preaching and preaching and preaching and preaching. And you can still look like a tree. But as soon as the Holy One, just one touch.
Solo un toque.
Just one touch.
Solo un toque.
That woman who was bleeding. The woman who was bleeding, who had the issue of blood. For years she went to the doctor. You may never have a disease like that, thank God. But if you're the one with the disease, think about this. She went to every doctor, they could not stop the bleeding.
La mujer que sangraba, buscaba ayuda siempre.
And finally she heard about Jesus.
Pero finalmente
he was in the crowd.
Entre la multitud.
But she said, if I can only.
Pero ella decía,
I don't want to hear about the Pharisees preaching that law. If I can only just touch his
heart,
just once,
solo uno.
I know,
just say,
I'm going to be healed, transformed.
Yo voy a ser sanada y transformada.
She couldn't get to him.
Ella se fue.
The crowds were so thick.
La multitud era enorme.
But that didn't stop what you see.
Pero ella see, llegó.
He wants somebody who's hungry.
El dijo, alguien me tocó.
It's not going to happen like this.
No fue algo así.
Doesn't happen like that.
No pasó así. Y se sentó.
It happens like this.
Pasó así.
It happens like this.
¿Cómo?
I can't walk through the crowd. I'll go underneath the legs.
Yo no podía ir caminando. Fue caminando entre la multitud, así que se fue gateando.
If I
can, peleando, arrastrándose, alcanzando.
Even Jesus.
Hasta Jesús.
Who touched me? Who touched me?
¿Quién me tocó?
The disciple said, "Look, who touched me? There's a crowd around you. Everybody.
Una multitud alrededor. Mucha gente me tocó.
They didn't even understand him." He said, "No."
No. Jesús le dijo, "No."
No. Somebody.
Alguien.
Touched me.
Me tocó.
In a way.
En la forma.
Somebody touched me in a way.
Alguien me tocó de la forma correcta.
That captured me.
Que me llamó la atención.
That captured me. Oh, this woman.
Esa mujer.
This woman was desperate for Jesus.
Porque estaba desesperada por Jesús.
She was desperate for Jesus.
Estaba desesperada por Jesús.
You know what desperate means?
¿Ustedes saben lo que significa estar desesperado?
Morning and night.
Día y noche.
Lord, if I don't touch you,
Señor, si no te toco,
I'm going to die.
Voy a morir.
If I don't touch you,
si no te toco,
you're my only hope.
Tú eres mi única esperanza.
In this world,
en este mundo,
I've got to have an encounter with you.
Yo necesito un encuentro
I
contigo.
Don't want religion anymore.
Porque ya yo necesito salir de esto.
I'm going to die in religion.
Voy a morir.
I want an encounter.
Yo
quiero un encuentro.
I'm a priest, Lord. You purchased me as a priest.
Soy sacerdote.
And I will touch the hem of your garment.
Pero yo quiero tocar el manto.
I will touch. I will touch.
Voy a tocar
the hem of your garment. And the Lord says to you, everyone.
Y el Señor dirá,
everyone.
Cada uno, todos.
Say something. He said, everyone.
Cada uno.
Listen to the word. It's out from his mouth. Everyone who asks and keeps on asking shall receive. Everyone who knocks and keeps on knocking do you want him?
¿Qué tan fuerte deseas?
Are you happy with the way things are?
¿Estás feliz con todo lo que pasa?
Then you'll keep it.
Manténlo.
He said, unless you can love me,
porque tú me amas, yo sí,
and hate him.
Y lo quieres a
él. Are you married? Praise God. And you look in love. It's true. I'm a believer in marriage. I'm a believer in being in love. I'm in love with my wife.
But listen,
unless you can love me,
la forma en que me amas,
and in comparison hate him,
es parecido al amor que
hay entre unless you can love me,
la forma en que me amas a mí,
and hate her in comparison,
se parece.
You're not worthy of me. He's not telling you not to love your wife. But you got to desire him much more. Much more than her. She has to desire him. Much more than a husband. That's just the way it is. If you're content and happy the way things are, then you'll stay this way. But he's lucky. Is there anybody in this place who has to have the fullness of me, says the Lord? Is there anybody who wants to be enveloped in my glory?
Aquí hay gente que quiere ser envuelta en la gloria.
Is there anyone in this place who desires to carry the glory of God?
Hay gente que quiere llevar la gloria de Dios.
Amén.
Aleluya.
Gloria.
Holy Communion.
La Santa Cena, la Santa Comunión.
He gave me the book, the Lord gave me the book on worship 19 years ago.
Él me dio el libro de la oración hace unos años, 19 años.
But as soon as I finished the book, the Lord started giving me Holy Communion.
Pero cuando terminé el libro, el Señor empezó a hablar sobre la Santa Comunión.
I said, I don't understand. You gave me the worship, what now, why hold it? He didn't answer me.
Entonces no entendía, si ya tenía la oración, ¿por qué era comunión?
Until he made me understand what it was.
Pero me hizo entenderlo después.
Chapter 6 of John.
Capítulo 6 de Juan.
You can enjoy this.
Va a disfrutar.
Church takes Holy Communion once a month, I think.
Nosotros aquí en la iglesia se toma la Santa Cena una vez al mes. Sí.
Sí. chapter 6.
Capítulo 6.
It starts in verse 53.
Empieza en el
versículo
53.
But I'm going to go backwards. I'm going to go to the end of the chapter and tell you what happened.
Pero después va a empezar a hablar sobre lo que pasa antes.
Jesus released these words.
Jesús dio esas palabras.
You know what the disciple said?
¿Qué fue lo que dijo?
This teaching is unbearable.
Esta enseñanza.
Who can be expected?
¿Quién va a esperar?
To listen to such teaching.
¿Qué va a esperar escuchar esta enseñanza?
They walked away.
Y les dijo, vayan y hablen.
Then he went to Peter and said, Peter, you going to walk away also?
Y entonces le dijo, Peter, Pedro, ¿usted también quiere? Vaya.
Peter says, where am I going to go?
Pero Pedro dijo, ¿a dónde?
He didn't say this is a great ride. He says, where else can I go?
¿Qué más tengo que hacer?
Who else has the words?
¿Quién tiene esas palabras?
Who else has the words?
¿Quién más tiene esas palabras?
To eternal life.
Esa vida.
He says, flesh and blood did not reveal that to you, Peter.
No es la carne la que lo va a revelar, Pedro.
But my Father in heaven.
Es mi Padre del cielo.
So I wonder what's going to happen tonight.
Lo que va a pasar esta noche.
If you're going to also say,
está bien lo que se le dijo.
Jacob, I love you, but this teaching is unbearable. Jesus said,
Jesús dijo,
6 times,
6 veces,
I am the bread,
yo soy el pan,
that comes down from heaven,
que vino del cielo,
my flesh,
mi carne,
is genuine food,
está ahí, para lanzarte la cruz,
my flesh,
mi carne,
is genuine food.
Será puesta ahí.
My blood.
Mi sangre.
The Holy Spirit is so thick here. The Holy Spirit is so thick here.
El Espíritu Santo.
My blood.
Mi sangre.
Is genuine drink.
Será bebida.
He who eats my flesh.
Aquí está mi pan, mi carne.
And drinks my blood,
y bebe mi sangre,
shall never die,
y nunca morirás,
shall have eternal life,
y vas a tener vida eterna,
and I shall raise him up,
y yo les voy a mostrar cómo levantarse,
on the last day,
el último día.
He who eats my flesh,
aquí está mi carne,
and drinks my blood,
y bebe mi sangre,
shall abide in me, forever,
por siempre.
But he who does not eat my flesh,
come mi carne,
and drink my blood,
y bebe mi sangre,
has no life in him,
porque es donde está la vida.
He who eats my flesh,
aquí está mi carne,
and drinks my blood,
y bebe mi sangre,
shall never die,
nunca morirás,
shall have eternal life,
vas a tener vida eterna,
and I shall raise him up on the last day,
y vamos a ser levantados el último día.
He who eats my flesh,
aquí está mi carne,
and drinks my blood,
y bebe mi sangre,
shall abide in me forever,
y vas a estar en mí por siempre.
But he who does not eat my flesh,
pero no solamente comer la carne,
he who does not drink my blood,
y no es solamente tomar,
in other words, he who is not willing to eat my flesh and drink my blood,
no es la voz literal que se coma mi carne y se toma mi sangre,
has no life in him,
porque no hay vida en eso.
I have a question for you now.
Tengo una pregunta para ustedes.
Escuche. Learn from other people's mistakes.
Hay que aprender de los errores de las personas.
So close.
Tan cerca.
yet so far.
Y tan lejos.
So close.
Tan cerca.
But yet.
Pero no todavía.
This is the question.
Esta es la pregunta.
Did he mean that this is just a representation?
¿Eso es solo una representación?
Of his body?
De su cuerpo?
And this is a representation of his blood?
¿Eso es una representación de su sangre?
What did he mean?
Oh.
Of course, spiritually.
Desde el punto de vista espiritual.
That this is his flesh.
Esa es su carne.
When you pray over it.
Cuando oramos.
And this is his blood.
Y esa es su sangre.
So my question to you now is, I want to know how many in here believe that this is a representation. In other words, Jacob, it's not the body and not the blood. It's a representation.
¿Cuántos de ustedes creen que esto es solo una representación? Porque hoy es una de la carne y la sangre.
Don't be embarrassed. Raise your hands. How many believe it's a representation and not the body?
¿Cuántos de ustedes creen que es una representación?
Let me see. Do they understand what I just asked them?
¿Están entendiendo lo que les pregunto?
Okay, let me ask the question again. How many believe that this is a representation?
¿Cuántos creen que eso es una representación?
And this is a representation.
De la sangre y el cuerpo de Cristo.
Raise your hands.
Levanten las manos.
How many believe?
¿Cuántos creen?
That when you pray.
Que podemos orar.
This turns in.
Y que esto se convierta
to the flesh of Christ
en la carne de Cristo.
Amen.
And his blood.
Y su sangre.
Raise your hands.
Levanten las manos.
Amen.
Wow, we got a half and half.
Tenemos mitad y mitad.
Now, get excited. It is the flesh.
Esa es la carne.
And it is the blood.
Esa es la sangre.
We're going to go to scripture, Corinthians.
1 Corinthians chapter 11.
1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians.
Chapter 11. Let me get
mine.
Capítulo
11.
Here's my Bible.
No, Jacob.
Oh, okay. 1 Corinthians.
1 Corinthians.
11. Okay. 1 Corinthians.
Chapter 11.
Chapter 11. 1 Corinthians, chapter 11. Hold on here. 1 Corinthians. Oops, okay, 1 Corinthians. I got it. Chapter 11. Yes, chapter 11. Okay. Chapter 11. Okay. 1 Corinthians, chapter 11. And, okay. We're going to start at verse 23.
Capítulo 11,
versículo 23. You got that? 1 Corinthians.
1 Corintios 11, versículo
23. Verse 23. 1 Corinthians, chapter 11. We start at verse 23. Yes?
Yes.
Yes. Escuche. Don't fall asleep.
No se duerman.
For I receive from the Lord himself.
Porque yo recibí del Señor lo que también os he enseñado.
Paul is speaking.
Que el Señor Jesús.
The instruction.
La noche que fue entregado tomó el pan.
Which I pass on to you
y
now.
Que es lo que vamos a darles ahora.
Paul is speaking. He received the instruction from Christ.
Que es una instrucción de Jesús.
And he says, now I'm going to pass this on to you what I got from Christ.
Porque es lo que tiene de Jesús.
Oh, this is beautiful. That the Lord Jesus, on the night in which he was betrayed, took bread.
Y habiendo dado gracias, partió y dijo.
And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said,
y habiendo dado gracias, se lo partió y dijo, tomad y comed, que esto es mi cuerpo, que por vosotros es partido, haces esto en memoria de mí.
This is my body.
Este es mi cuerpo.
Which is offered as a sacrifice for you.
Va a ser entregado el sacrificio por ustedes.
Do this.
Haz esto.
In affectionate remembrance of me.
En recuerdo de mí.
Saying this is my body.
Este es mi cuerpo.
For every time you eat this bread and drink this cup,
cada vez que tome este pan y tome este vino,
you are proclaiming the Lord's death.
Así que pues todas las veces que comeréis este pan y beberéis esta copa ante la muerte del Señor, anunciaréis
until
hasta que Él venga.
Until He comes.
Hasta que Él venga.
Comprende. So that whoever, listen, here it comes now, it's just going to start now. Pay attention. Is she listening? I just don't want her to miss it. Yeah, tap her on the shoulder. Come, escuche. Okay, I didn't want you to miss it. For every time you eat this bread,
así que pues todas las veces que coma este pan
and drink this cup,
y bebieres esta copa,
you are proclaiming the Lord's death until He comes. Now, verse 27.
La muerte del Señor anunciarás hasta que Él venga.
So then whoever eats the bread or drinks the cup of the Lord,
de manera que cualquiera que comiera este pan y bebiera esta copa del Señor indignamente,
in a way that is unworthy,
indignamente,
will be guilty,
será culpado,
of profaning and sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord.
Será culpado del cuerpo y la sangre del Señor.
In other words, he's saying,
en otras palabras,
everyone who takes that,
si alguien toma eso,
and has really not repented,
y no tiene un arrepentimiento verdadero,
will be guilty of sinning against the body and the blood of the Lord.
Va a ser culpable de pecar en contra del cuerpo y la sangre de Cristo.
Comprende?
Amén. Amén.
Now, verse 28. We're not done. Listen. But a person must prayerfully examine himself, which is what Lorianne has been talking about yet last night about worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness, repentance. Yes?
Ayer Lori estuvo hablando de esto, de ese arrepentimiento verdadero, porque el versículo 28 dice: por tanto, pruébese que cada uno a sí mismo coma así del pan y beba de la copa.
But a person must prayerfully examine himself and his relationship to Christ.
Porque el que come y bebe indignamente, sin discernir el cuerpo del Señor, juicio come y bebe para sí.
And only when he has done this,
por cual hay muchos enfermos y debilitados entre vosotros y muchos duermen.
Should he eat this bread and drink the cup? So preach what I'm preaching now. And only when he has done this, and only when he has done this,
si cada uno hace esto,
he has to examine himself,
sin examinarse a sí mismo,
should he eat the bread and drink the cup?
Puede pecar, pero si se examina a sí mismo, se hace, si convierte ese verdadero arrepentimiento, es digno de comer el cuerpo y la sangre de Dios.
Now, does everybody understand so far?
¿Están entendiendo?
Amen.
Now, verse 29.
Verso 29.
For anyone,
para aquel que come y bebe,
who eats and drinks
indignamente.
I just want you to preach what I'm reading. For anyone who eats and drinks,
para cada uno que coma y bebe,
without reverence,
sin arrepentimiento,
and heartfelt gratitude,
y que no tenga en su corazón arrepentido y en gratitud,
for the sacrifice of Christ,
por el sacrificio de Cristo,
eats and drinks a judgment,
come y bebe el juicio,
on himself,
sobre sí mismo.
If he does not recognize,
si no reconoce,
if he does not recognize,
si no reconoce,
if he does not recognize,
si no reconoce,
the body of Christ,
el cuerpo de Cristo.
Verse 30.
Verso 30.
And here's the proof.
Y aquí está la prueba.
This careless, careless, it means you don't really care, it's not really true.
Sí, 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 no lo creen.
And unworthy,
y el valor,
participation,
de participar,
is the reason, listen, is the reason,
es la razón,
why many among you,
De muchos de ustedes.
Why many among you?
Que muchos de ustedes.
Are weak.
Son débiles.
And sick.
Y enfermos.
And have died.
Y van a morir.
He's saying those people who haven't realized that this was the body and the blood.
Si la gente no se da cuenta de que en realidad es el cuerpo y la sangre de Cristo.
They take it as a normal Sunday activity.
Y lo toma como una actividad normal de un domingo.
But they really weren't serious.
Pero si no lo ven seriamente.
About the repentance.
A través del arrepentimiento.
And it says this is the reason.
Esa es la razón.
Why many get sick in the body of Christ.
Por eso es que hay enfermos en el cuerpo de Cristo.
And they die.
Y van a morir.
Now this has always puzzled me.
Pero no es solamente por eso.
Let me tell you why it confused me.
Déjeme decirles por qué se hace confundir.
By the stripes that wounded him,
a través de las heridas,
I am healed.
Yo soy sano.
By the stripes that wounded him,
porque a través de las heridas y de las
llagas, I am healed.
Yo soy sano.
But Jacob, you didn't. You didn't look at sister so and so. I don't care. I don't base my faith on somebody else.
Yo no estoy, pero Jacob, lo que va a pasar afuera.
I don't know how you're living your life outside of this church.
Yo no sé cómo vive usted su vida fuera de la iglesia.
His word cannot lie.
Puede ser una mentira.
Now this is the question.
Esa es la pregunta.
If this,
si esto,
was just a representation,
es solo una representación,
you know, you bought it at the store. It's called Nabisco cracker.
Yo puedo ir y conseguirlo.
Just a cracker.
Es una galleta, un pan.
And we use it to represent the body.
Y lo usamos para representar el cuerpo.
Whether I repent or not, is a piece of cracker going to kill me? Is a silly little cracker just going to kill me?
See,
you know?
No.
No. If it was only a representation, doesn't matter whether I repent or not, a cracker is not going to kill me. And this?
Y esto.
This is Welch's grape juice.
Eso es jugo de uvas, Welch.
That's what they call it, Welch's grape juice.
Jugo de uvas.
If it's just grape juice.
Solo jugo de uvas.
Whether I repent or not. Grape juice is not going to kill me.
El jugo de uvas no me va a matar.
See you know. See you know.
See you know.
Sí, sí.
Of course not.
Grape
juice is
grape
juice. But
pero,
if it's his body
si es de su cuerpo,
and blood
y su sangre,
do you remember the priests in the Old Testament?
¿Ustedes se acuerdan los sacerdotes en el Antiguo Testamento?
They used to go into the Holy of Holies.
Ellos solían estar en el lugar santísimo.
With bells.
Con
Do you know why they wore bells?
¿Sabes por qué?
Because if you did not repent.
Porque si no estaba arrepentido.
And were not right with God.
Y no estaba en la regla de Dios.
And you go into the Holy of Holies.
Y entraba al lugar santísimo.
You will die.
Usted moría.
Holiness
por su santidad
will kill you
te mataba.
If you are not prepared to enter into
si
it.
No estaba preparado para entrar.
This has not changed.
No había.
You are a priest now.
Y no había chance. Ahora nosotros
this is a whole new time in your life.
Este es el tiempo en sus vidas.
The Lord did not make you come back here.
El Señor no hace que vuelva otra vez.
You could have run from this and say, I'm done with this thing. You've gone too far.
Porque puede decir, ya yo lo hice, me voy lejos.
You are a priest now.
Por eso es que ustedes son los sacerdotes.
And you are being prepared by the Lord.
Y ustedes serán preparados por
el Señor. To come into the throne room of God.
Para entrar en el trono de Dios.
And you've got to come in the right way.
Y vamos a entrar en la forma correcta.
holiness, that holy communion will either give you life or it will kill you.
Porque la santidad a través de la santa comunión nos puede dar vida o nos puede matar.
But you see, you can't go back.
Y no podemos regresar.
Because if you say, oh, then I'm not going to take Holy Communion, then you're going to lose your salvation anyway, because it means you're going to stay in sin.
No es que se vaya a perder la salvación, porque es el nuestro estar en pecado. Pero tenemos que estar preparados para la comunión.
¿Comprende?
Amén. Amén.
It's all where we have to walk forward.
Es la única vía que tenemos.
You're entering into your priesthood.
Entrar en el modo sacerdotal.
But Jacob, I didn't count the cost.
Pero Jacob, yo no puedo pagar ese costo. No puedo medir el costo.
It's too late to think about that now.
Es muy tarde para pensar en eso.
This is the war. Jacob, most people don't even get involved in this.
Pero Jacob, hay mucha gente que no cree en eso.
But don't you know the Christianity of today?
¿Ustedes saben que el cristianismo hoy
is not the same Christianity when Paul was alive?
Es no es el mismo cristianismo que antes.
But we better start waking up.
Por eso es que tenemos que despertarnos.
And returning to the Christianity that he had.
Y de regresar al cristianismo que él dejó.
¿Comprende? So every time now,
por eso cada vez,
you take the blood in the body.
Que tiene la sangre del cuerpo.
You're gonna let the Lord examine you before you take it.
Hay que hacer ese examen antes de tomarlo.
Comprende.
Yes, amen. Amen.
You're going to eat his flesh.
Porque vamos a comer su carne.
You're going to drink his blood.
Porque vamos a beber su sangre.
The life is in the blood.
Porque la vida está en la sangre.
In the Old Testament,
en el Antiguo Testamento,
you are not allowed to drink the blood of animals.
No estaba permitido que se bebiera la sangre de los animales.
Why?
¿Por qué?
Because there was demons in the animals.
Porque había contaminación en los animales.
You get possessed by demons.
Y había demonios que podían poseer.
But you're going to drink the blood of Christ.
Pero, bebiendo la sangre de Cristo.
And you are not going to get possessed by a demon.
Y no sé, no va a ser poseído por ningún demonio.
You are going to get possessed by the Christ.
Usted va a ser poseído por Cristo.
Amen. You're going to be devoured by him.
Usted va a ser ese recipiente.
You're going to be consumed by him.
Usted va a ser consumido por él.
In his holy fire.
Con su fuego santo.
And everything will be consumed.
Y cada cosa va a ser consumida.
Except the sweet aroma.
Excepto ese aroma dulce.
Of Christ.
De Cristo.
So that you can be a witness.
Ustedes van a ser testigos.
To the world.
Para el mundo.
That he is alive.
De que él está vivo.
It doesn't matter what age you are.
No importa cuántos años tengas.
Because it's not you who live anymore.
Porque no es usted el que vive más. Es Cristo en usted.
Comprende.
Amen.
So tonight.
Así que esta noche.
Oh, I'm excited.
Estoy muy emocionado.
Because I can't wait.
No puedo esperar.
Till you take that flesh.
De que tomemos esa carne.
And drink that.
Y bebamos la sangre.
Something is going to happen tonight.
Porque algo va a pasar dentro de mí esta noche.
So how do they come up or do you give it out?
Se lo reparte como un versículo.
Oh, go, give them out.
Que lo reparten.
How often?
¿Qué tan frecuente?
Do I take Holy Communion?
Tomamos la Santa Comunión.
No, not me. I take mine twice a day. Comprende, listen. You are, everybody listening, know your servant. I take Holy Communion in the morning. And in the evening. Jacob, you're crazy.
Jacob, estás loco.
No, I'm not.
No, yo no.
Escuche. Jesus said,
Jesús dijo,
don't toil, don't work,
no trabajes,
for the food that perishes.
Por la comida.
What is the food that perishes? What is the food, that, the food you eat?
La comida que comemos.
And goes out the other end.
Y que sale.
Comprende? Don't work for that food.
No es para esa comida.
Work for the food.
Trabajo por el alimento.
That leads to eternal life.
Que te da vida eterna.
That the Son of God will give you tonight.
Pero que el Hijo de Dios te está dando esta noche.
Comprende? You eat 2-3 meals a day.
Estás comiendo 3 veces al día.
Every day.
Todos los días.
I'm going to at least drink his blood and eat his flesh morning morning why? I'm hungry for him. When you're not hungry you don't eat, but I'm hungry. I'm hungry for the Christ.
Yo tengo hambre de Cristo.
Eat his flesh.
Comer su sal, su carne.
This is what gives you life.
Es por eso que te vas a vivir.
This, the flesh profits.
Esa es la recompensa. Hola.
Every morning.
Cada mañana.
In the blood.
La vida está en la sangre.
What life, Jacob?
Pero cuál vida, Jacob?
His loving kindness.
Su amor.
His compassion.
Su compasión.
His resurrection power.
El poder de su resurrección.
The fellowship of his suffering.
Es el precio por el sufrimiento.
His wisdom.
Su sabiduría.
His knowledge.
Su conocimiento.
His insight and understanding.
Está dentro de ese término.
His anointing.
Su unción.
His holiness.
Su santidad.
His peace.
Su paz.
He wants you to be a witness for him.
Quien quiere ser un testigo de él.
He has left this for you.
Tengo esto para nosotros.
He has not left you alone.
No te dejo ahí.
You can drink of him.
Podemos beber.
Eat of him.
Comerlo.
Every morning.
Cada mañana.
Every evening.
Cada.
Every morning.
Cada mañana.
I guarantee you.
Te garantizo.
I said, I guarantee you.
Te garantizo.
After eating this in the morning and drinking this at night, morning and night, the fire of God will burn from you. He will transform you that they will not recognize you. He cannot lie. Let every man and every devil be a liar. But Christ cannot.
Pero Cristo no puede mentir.
What an honor it is.
Es un honor estar aquí.
To eat his flesh.
Para comer su carne.
And drink his blood tonight with you.
Y tomar su sangre.
You are the priests.
Porque no somos los sacerdotes.
That are going to be here when I'm gone.
Están aquí.
And you will have to carry the next generation.
Y ustedes llevan esto a la siguiente generación.
So first we have to repent.
Primero, el arrepentimiento.
I know we repented yesterday. But I never get tired of repenting.
Pero, si no tuve tiempo.
So you can pray with me or you can... Lorianne, go ahead. You do the repentance with the money. Go ahead.
Okay. Vamos de nuevo con el arrepentimiento. Voy a dar un ejemplo de la oración de arrepentimiento.
But I cannot repent for you.
No, ella no se puede arrepentir por ustedes.
So in Romans chapter 2 verse 4,
en Romanos 2 verso 4,
we are told it is the goodness of the Lord that leads us to true repentance.
Porque es la bondad de Dios la que nos lleva a ese verdadero arrepentimiento.
So Father, in the name of Jesus,
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús,
I ask you to search our hearts.
Yo te pido que busques en los corazones.
Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you to shine your light into our hearts.
Señor, en el nombre de Jesús, te pido que brille tu luz en cada corazón.
Show us the things that displease you.
Muéstranos las cosas que te gustan.
And give us the grace and the mercy to turn from them.
Y muéstranos las cosas de las que tenemos que arrepentirnos a través de tu gracia y tu misericordia.
Lord Jesus, you said in Matthew chapter 5, only the pure in heart shall see God.
Porque Jesús, tú dices en Mateo que solamente los puros de corazón van a poder ver.
So Father, we pray for clean hands and a pure heart and a right spirit.
Por eso, Señor, te clamamos por un corazón puro para poder verte.
Holy Spirit, Spirit of truth, convict us of all sin, righteousness, and judgment.
Espíritu Santo, muéstranos el pecado para poder arrepentirnos.
Heavenly Father, I repent of the sins of the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life.
Señor, yo me arrepiento de los pecados que he tenido en la mente, de los pecados de la carne que me alejan de ti.
I repent of all idolatry, laziness, gluttony, backbiting, gossip, slander.
Yo, Señor, me arrepiento de toda blasfemia, de toda pereza, de todo chisme, de toda lujuria, de toda gula.
I repent for ever believing the lies of the enemy, for ever thinking this world is my home. I repent for every time I've grieved your precious Holy Spirit. I repent for not taking this walk more serious.
Me arrepiento, Señor, de haber escuchado las mentiras del enemigo, de no haber sido digno, de haber renegado de tu gloria, de haber pecado y de no ser digno de ti.
I repent for not loving my husband enough, or not loving my wife enough, the way you want me to love.
A mí me arrepiento, Señor, de no amar a mi esposo o a mi esposa en la forma que tú quieres que lo ame.
I repent of all prayerlessness, all distractions, all double-mindedness and unbelief.
También me arrepiento de no poner atención, de no orar lo suficiente, de tener un doble humor, un doble comportamiento.
I repent for all self-righteousness, for ever thinking I'm better than anyone else.
Me arrepiento de pensar que hay otras cosas mejores que estar aquí.
I repent, Father, of ever having unforgiveness, bitterness, resentment, anger in my heart.
Señor, te pido que me liberes de toda amargura, de todo enojo, de toda dureza de corazón.
I repent of all disobedience, all lying, all gossiping. I repent, Father, for all grumbling and complaining.
Me arrepiento, Señor, de los chismes, de la mentira. También me arrepiento de la duda y del temor.
I repent for not coming in my prayer closet when you were waiting for me in my prayer closet morning and night. I repent of distractions of my cell phone, YouTube, all distraction. I repent of all people pleasing.
Me arrepiento, Señor, de las distracciones del teléfono, de las redes sociales. Señor, me arrepiento de todo lo que me aleje de ti y no buscarte en la mañana y en la noche.
Father, I ask you to have mercy upon me.
Señor, te pido misericordia sobre mí.
Wash me in the blood of Jesus. Put my sins as far as the east to the west to be remembered no more.
Señor, lávame con tu sangre, con mis pecados, al este y al oeste, bien lejos, donde no puedan alcanzar.
Father, help me to be the aroma of Christ.
Señor,
Señor, ayúdame de tener el aroma de Cristo, para tener el aroma de Cristo. I repent of all sins, known and unknown. Everything I've ever done since the day I've been born, of that I haven't repented of. I repent now, Father, and I turn to you.
Señor, me arrepiento de los pecados nombrados y no nombrados, de aquellos que yo pequé desde mi nacimiento. Padre, en el nombre de Jesús.
Now there's one sin that every church we go to that Satan has the body of Christ locked up in.
Hay un pecado que la iglesia tiene con respecto al pan y a la carne y al vino, que la sangre.
And that sin is unforgiveness, bitterness, anger, and resentment.
Y ese pecado es la amargura, el resentimiento, la falta de perdón.
And the Lord Jesus says in Matthew 6, unless we can forgive everyone who has ever hurt us, our Heavenly Father will not forgive us for what we did to Jesus.
Porque en Mateo la palabra dice, perdona al que te ha lastimado, porque si no, no verás el reino de los cielos.
Last night we went through that.
La noche pasamos por eso.
And practically the whole church came up and was delivered.
Y prácticamente toda la iglesia vino y lo recibió.
And you're free.
Y todos somos libres.
But if there's somebody who came here tonight who's new,
pero si hay alguien que no vino ayer,
who wasn't here last night,
que no estuvo anoche,
please pay attention.
Ponga atención.
People who have unforgiveness in their heart,
porque la gente, si no tiene perdón en su corazón,
cannot go to heaven.
No va a ir al cielo.
Jesus said, if you cannot forgive those who have willfully sinned against you,
si no eres, Jesús dijo, si no eres capaz de perdonar al que te hizo algo,
your heavenly Father cannot forgive you.
Porque si no, el Padre no te va a perdonar.
If he doesn't forgive you, then you die in your sin.
Porque si no, si usted no te perdona, si hiciste un pecado.
And if you die in your sin, you go to hell.
Y si usted muere en pecado, va al infierno.
That's not the will of God for you.
Y eso no es lo que Dios quiere.
If you were not here last night,
si usted no estuvo ayer aquí,
you're new and you have unforgiveness, I'm begging you, please.
Yo le pido, por favor,
come up now.
Y venga al frente.
And Christ is going to set you free like he set at least 85 people last night free.
Y pero el Señor lo va a hacer libre, como lo hizo libres a todas las personas.
And if you're just one, please.
Si hay una sola persona que ayer no estuvo, le invitamos a pasar el fuego.
We miss anybody.
Para que no se lo pierda nada.
Thank God.